All right, guys, so this one was actually similar to one that we did earlier where it kind of looked like a terpbutyl, but it wasn't. My longest chain would look like that. So that would be, it looks like six carbons. One, two, three, four, five, six. So my root is going to be hexane. All right, now I have to decide which one gets the number one. Is it red or is it blue? And for this, I need to go ahead and see which one has the closest substituent. Red has a substituent on two. Blue has a substituent on two. So far, there's a tie. So then I go to the next substituents. Red has its next substituent on five. Blue has its next substituent, I keep doing that, still on two, because there were two methyls in that location. So it turns out that even though the iodine is all the way over here, my number one is still going to be the blue. Okay? So what that means is that now I look at substituents. So for substituents, what do I got? I've got a 2,2 dimethyl. And it looks like I also have a 5 iodo. Now all I have to do is piece that together. In terms of alphabetical order, which one would come first? Remember, di doesn't count, so I look at M versus I, and I comes in the alphabet first, so it would be 5 iodo, 2,2 dimethyl hexane. Not so bad, right? Now, so hopefully if you have questions, let me know, but if not, move on to the next question. Now, I'm just going to let you guys know, the hardest part about the next question is actually just figuring out which chain you're going to use. So I want you guys to pay extra careful attention to that, because this one's a little bit tricky. So go ahead and get started.